I love these toothbrushes. I got my first one maybe in like 2006, and this is my third one since. Stuff just brushes your teeth so fucking good. Get that. I don't like using this toothpaste because sometimes I get paranoid from all the conspiracy theories out there saying fluoride's bad for us. That's what I have right now. Not in the best shape for me right now, I guess. But I will be getting lean, and I don't have a pump right now. I'm pretty much cold. Look at that peak. I've been using something old school on my skin to keep me hydrated. After I use, like, you know, that body scrub, I've been using this. This is what I used to use a long time ago. And I put it on, you know, whenever my skin feels a little dry. Or sometimes I used to actually wear this in the sun. And it really makes a difference on my skin. Now, I have sensitive skin. So, you know, I used to break out and I would, like, pretty much, you know, I cleaned things up, you know, using different scrubs or whatever, and I actually get some cool announcements about the body scrub I've been talking about, that I have potentially joined the team, but we'll talk about that another time. But this, so say I use body scrubs, exfoliants, whatever, but I still will get, like, you know, scarring if I get blemishes or whatever, and stretch marks, all that. Well, this, it was something extra I used to use, and I would use this even in the sunlight, and when I use it in this, like, in the sunlight, I still haven't really, I'm still not all here yet. Alright, I used to use this in this, like, literally when I go out tanning, and it used to help me a little bit, get a nice, you know, color to my skin. I use some cool stuff now, really tans me, because, I mean, my skin's not naturally, I'm like a light-skinned individual, I got a red undertones, but moral story is, this stuff, as a lotion, is probably my favorite. I stopped wearing it because my buddy's girlfriend was giving me shit about smelling like chocolate all the time. And I lived with my buddy, so she was there all the time, and she just annoyed me. So I stopped wearing it because I didn't want to hear her bitch. And then I just got used to not using it anymore. But I'm telling you, this makes me smell real good. Sometimes I like to put this shit on before the gym, so I'm looking all, like, oiled up and shit. But I'm not sure yet. I have to go into the sock drawer. My magical sock drawer. I got underwear in here. My Under Armour long leggings. I need to get new gym clothes. I need to hit up the mall and just get some new shit. Let's see. All I wear is Nike socks. I mean, just sitting here at the camera, you can see the old ones. These old ones look like fucking pleasure socks that have been used too much. I hate old socks, too. I need them. Look at the different colors. They're all black. You can see the ones that I use all the friggin' time. I need to get nice, fresh pairs. And I get no more good tanks. This is my beater collection. And all my gym shorts. I'm really rocking the Nike Dry Fits still. I like those shorts. I got them on today. There's some old Under Armour. I get a, you know, sell or donate or something, because I don't like these anymore. But I gotta figure out what I'm wearing. Figure out what's next for me. Look at that big bed. A big mess. Figure out what tank top I'm wearing. Yeah, about the body scrub. So I was getting the product for free, you know, helping them out. But thanks to you guys, I've helped them out so much. I am now like officially part of the team for the Bay Body Body Scrub. The stuff I've been using before it was being sold for like a year, and that's what kept my skin pretty nice. Here are the new containers. So now I'm officially, full disclosure, I'm officially part of the team. So now it's gonna suck because you're gonna think I'm trying to say something, but I just tell you guys how it is. I tell you everything I use and everything that I do pretty much. So these are the new containers. They had some issues with the other containers and leakage, so they had to like be a little ghetto with the taping. The good thing is they have no connection to outside sources. Like they're all local, right? It was all local thing. You know, like farmers markets, stuff like that. But now, because of me, they've expanded. Like I'm pretty much the global voice right now so far. And you guys responded well. So I heard some, you know, people messaging me about issues with the containers and leakage and all that stuff, and they were getting emails, and you know, I came together with them and I was like, we need a sexier container, you know, because they wanted my opinion, you know, because my fans, I don't know what to call everyone, but my followers and my subscribers, you know, and the people that bought it and follow me, you know, were talking to me about it, and I said, we need some sexier containers. So here they are. Look how fucking beautiful they are. So I'm now part of the team. Wasn't sure if I was just gonna be like sponsored or what, or actually really become part of the team. So now I'm actually really part of the team. So yeah, if you guys end up trying that, listen, if you do try it or not, that's up to you. I'm not gonna push anything on you. But if you do try it, yeah, let me know what you like change, because it's funny. Now I can say we're trying to make it the best possible. The product is perfect. It's the probably the packaging and whatever, but I like being a part of this stuff. I love shit like this. But I'm the connection to all you guys. So whatever you guys say, I'm reading these comments, so I can like tweak anything. You know what I mean? If you want something better or whatever, I love the input. I can also, you know, I have that clothing shit that I'm doing soon. I'll have my own clothing line. Because what happens is, like I just said, I need more gym clothes, right? But I don't want to just be buying them and, like, choosing their designs. I want my own designs. I want my own style that I like. So why not just make my own and wear it? You know, instead of giving my money to someone else, I'm just gonna make my own style that I really like and rock those and feel proud that I did it myself. And if anyone likes what I make and they don't have the time or they don't want to develop all theirs and put all in the research and all that shit, you can just get what I get. If you don't like it, you don't get it. I don't care. I mean, granted, yeah, I would like you to get my shit, but if you don't, whatever, man. It's not a big deal. See, like, for instance, I gotta figure out what the hell I'm wearing today. Oh, my shoes are a mess. I got these. I fucking love these. The Supras. These things are fucking badass. But I need to clean this shit. I got clothes that I don't even know about. But some of this shit's old as fuck. I like styles like this, Under Armour. I don't really rock these anymore. But since today's back day, I probably want to show off some sort of lattage in the gym. What do we got? I can wear this red stringer. That shit's tight as fuck on me. A lot of stuff don't even fit me anymore, to be honest with you. I'm one of those clothes hoards. Oh, I can rock one of my new tanks. Yeah, I think I'm just going to rock a tank. I don't know if I'm gonna have any lats popping out, but a buddy of mine, well, actually not really a buddy of mine, someone hooked me up and they got me these tanks off my Amazon wish list, which is fucking awesome. Also, a big thanks to Mike and Nevin for helping contribute to this channel with the production and everything. I appreciate it. Yeah. So maybe I'll rock this one. I don't know if I should show off the lats today. I kind of like showing them off more when I'm all tanned up. This is a good stringer tank too that I rock. That'd be good on chest day. Alright. I think I'm just going to rock a standard tank. You guys know what my lats look like, I think. Fuck it. You know what? Let's get crazy. Let's go red. Alright, I'm going to throw this tank on. Alright, I think this is what we're going with today. Trim this. Let me comb that little beard. It's going to be the... what I'm going to rock today to the gym. If it, I wish it was push day. I get swollen in these, like pretty much double in size. But now you'll be able to see some lats. Hopefully, you know, if I'm working out. I mean, when I'm working out. I like these things. I want to make a bunch of tank tops like this, but hopefully better material. You can see the material is kind of shitty. I want to make some, like, I can't describe it. But I want to make some stringers like this, but I can't describe the material. I have to find out what it's called. But it's just a lot nicer than this. But everyone used to always ask me where I get my stringers. And honestly, I just get them offline. These are like no-name brands, most of them. This one's like some gym, Pitbull gym. And I was rocking their stuff. But honestly, yeah, they look fucking awesome. But the quality, when you get up close, just looks like, I don't know, like your mom made it in like her garage or something. I don't fucking know. Oh, get clear. There we are. So I'm going to show you what my new back workout is. And it's so much better. I put a lot of philosophy into it. Everything I do has to be done for, you know, a particular reason. And a lot of you guys might get upset with what you see me working on. You'll be, where's this? Where's that? You don't do this. But I'm just trying to get the most effective workout I can. So I select the most optimal exercises in my mind. So we'll see. Oh, good morning. How are you? Well, today is, I don't even know what fucking day it is. Today is Wednesday, June 24th. Is 11:15. I'm going to the gym at noon, so I need to have my pre-workout meal right now. Let's see what we got here. Today's back and bicep day. All right, for my meal today, I'll be having my typical oatmeal, protein, chia seed, coconut oil. I still haven't had a sip of my coffee yet. Blueberries. Then I'll have my get shit done coffee. Wake me up. And I have 219 grams of watermelon. So let's see. If you guys don't already, make sure you follow me on Instagram here. You can pretty much see everything I eat. The muscle nerd. Wow. Who is that guy? Who is that? So check this out, alright? Anyways, what was I doing? Here's how I log everything. I put in the watermelon already. I'm gonna have, here's my whey protein I had. I had 30 grams, oatmeal, it's all set. Chia seeds, all set. Lock that in. Blueberries, all set. Coconut oil, where is it? There it is. All set. Add that in. Here will be breakfast meal one. 689 calories. I think that's everything. Here's the macro breakdown so far. 85 carbs, 39 protein, 22 grams of fat. And that will be breakfast pre-workout. So I'm gonna eat this up. So I'm gonna eat that up, start my day. I need to start off with start off right. This stuff's good. Try it out. Buddy!
Yo.
What are you doing, dog?
What are you doing, dog?
Are you going to the gym at noon, dog?
Yeah, dog.
Are you sure, dog? It sounds like you just woke up. You just wake up?
Yes.
Mumbles.
What are you getting to the gym?
Dude, I thought we were going at noon, dog.
Alright, dog.
Yo, you want me to get you at noon?
12:30.
12:30?
Yeah, bro.
Are you up playing Elder Scrolls all night?
Maybe.
You playing video games all night, huh, dog?
Maybe, dog. Maybe.
Damn, dude. How was that game? Good? Dude, you sound like an addict.
What, nigga?
You sound like a fucking addict, dude. Like, you have, like, an issue. You're ashamed to admit you're playing video games all night.
I ain't ashamed, nigga.
Damn, dude. Alright, so you want to go at, like, 12:30, eh?
Hey.
Alright, maybe I'll get some color outside until then. Alright, I'll call you in a little bit and I'll figure it out. We'll shoot for 12:30 though, I might pick you up.
What?
Shoot for 12:30 though, definitely, because I already ate breakfast and shit. I'm all hyped up, I had coffee.
Oh shit. Alright, sit over here now then.
What?
Head over here now then.
Alright. Right. This fucking kid. Yo, what do you think of that? Yeah, me too. Alright, I'm gonna make my pre-workout real quick and intro workout. So, I love these Gatorade cups. I don't think they make them like they used to anymore. These ones are old. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put in some modern BCAA. I'm gonna make sure I have the actual effective dose or actual serving size, which is like 13 grams. 8. Come on, baby. There you go, 13. So that's some serving size. I'm gonna drink that in the gym. My rice cooker for later. But here is the key. Just turn this off. To help it mix, to make it taste good and cold, you're gonna put in some ice cubes. Now it turns into like a shaker cup. I don't know what's going on outside. There it is. So that's that. I have that in the gym. It's hard to do things one-handed. Wouldn't mind if I had an extra hand. This is going to be pre-workout. And I mix my own ingredients. Beta-alanine. Or alanine. I don't fucking know. Creatine? I'm joking. Creatine. I'll take 5 grams of this. I'll take like almost 5 grams of this. I don't even need 5 grams, but it just ends up being 5 grams. And of course, the cheapest, most effective pre-workout. Caffeine. You know what? Let's get crazy. Let's get fucking crazy. No, man, let's not get crazy. I can't find it. Oh, there it is. Let's take some citrulline malate. A little extra pump. Huh? Why not? So what I'm going to do... So I'm going to start with my creatine. Now, you can take creatine anytime throughout the day. I just forget sometimes. And before I go to the gym, I remember. So, I'm just going to take it now. Really, I don't think it matters when you take it. It builds up in your system. So I got 5 grams in there. I'm going to speed this shit up. I want to get lifting. So I want to get some sunlight if I can. So right there is 5 grams. Now I'm doing the beta-alanine, which is, I think the effective dose is 3.2. But I like, this is stuff that makes you feel itchy. But it also increases your endurance. I like to feel itchy. It's, especially when it fucking all over me. I really just don't even care. Alright, citrulline malate, this gives you a pump. Usually you want to take 8 grams. Some people like take, I think 6 actually works as well. But most of the studies were at 8. And I'm gonna put in 6. Because I'm already fucking pumped up mentally. Alright. Put that shit away. Even though it doesn't go up here, I'm gonna put it up there for now. The coolest fucking spoons in the world. It's like a fucking magical sorcerer. Maybe a little unnecessary for this, but I love those spoons. I'm gonna take my caffeine pill. I'm gonna do, you know what? 200 milligrams is more than enough. I don't need to be cracked out. Down the hatch. That's right, unflavored. It tastes sour. I used to make my own pre-workout like that with some more ingredients. I have a video about it a couple years ago. And that was definitely an effective pre-workout that I made myself. I called it Rhino Blast. Make sure I have everything. I call it Rhino Blast because I felt like a fucking rhino after I drank it. One day I was out playing flag football And I took it, and my buddy was like, heard me running him down behind him. And he's like, what the fuck, dude? I'm like, what? He's like, it sounded like a rhino was behind me. And I was like, well, I took my Rhino Blast today. So I started calling my pre-workout Rhino Blast. Anyways, today's more of like a, I guess, get to know my personality. It's very interesting. All right, time to go get Nick.
Yo, dog.
Yo, man, I'm outside.
Alright.
Alright, bud.
Just go, piss real quick.
Alright. Oh man, I'm curious to see what Nick's persona is gonna be on camera, cause you know some people get like shy and shit when you put a camera in front of their face. So it might be funny to see him. We'll see what happens. Run up on this kid. What up, dog?
What up, though?
What's going on, son?
No, just kidding. Up.
Are you ready, son?
I hope so, dog.
What do you think of this camera?
Shit's sick. Is that the new one?
Yeah. I was thinking about returning it because they're coming out with a new one like in less than 15 days. That's it.
Get the new one, dog.
No, it's like $200 more, but it doesn't really do too much more.
You said it was like 4K.
How many weeks out are you?
This Saturday.
Oh shit, days out.
Like 4 or 5.
Look at the strategy in your bicep. Let me see it.
Which one? Huh?
Damn, son. 19 years old.
His industry, he was like, because he used to do this shit.
Yeah.
Why you were going, Jesus, bro.
Fitness industry is kind of weird, bro.
Yeah.
All right, Nick, start. It's all going to be edited.
You're in her way, though.
It's all right. I'll get above her.
like, this was our first exercise. We started with four sets, 10 to 12 reps. Very important, you do a full stretch all the way at the bottom. Explode up. See here, I'm sticking my head through and stretching. I stick my head through so I can get a real stretch on my lats, and then I contract, stretch all the way up, contract, stretching so much my lats are ripping out my back, getting stretch marks from ripping through my skin. We did four sets, 10 to 12 of that. Now Nick's doing these things a little off here. He didn't ever do these before. So he's learning them as we go. But this is another stretch and contract. Reason why I'm down here on my knees is to get that full stretch. See what I put my head through? That's to get that full stretch. And I pulled my chest, stretch, contract. Stretch, contract. And that's how I get that full lat activation.
Thank you.
use here, I'm doing the same thing as I do on all my lifts. I'm making sure I stretch, full lat stretch, and then I'm contracting. So I put my head down, I'm down on my knees, and I hump it. Like, boom, right to my lap. That's like that full pullover activation. These are really good to finish on. We did three sets of these. 10-12 reps. Follow these up with a face pulling, which will get our traps and rear delts, and some upright rows, which will actually hit our traps more than anything. I can't shrug right now because of my shoulder issue, which is healing, but upright rows really hits the traps a lot, and I like to develop that big, thick upper back. So what I think really makes me look big is just like my back and that upper back thickness, my traps. So a couple things to do, build your upper back. We do no rowing, if you haven't noticed. I just believe there's no doubt about it, you can build a great back with rowing, no doubt. I've rowed for years, but I did some research, I did a lot of reading and did a lot of thinking, and full range of motion is the most important. And here we're doing a full range of motion on all our lifts. The bigger the range of motion, you know, the more time under tension that muscle has to be under, and it works better under that full range of motion. So that's why I got rid of the rowing motion. You're just so limited with your range. Here we have such a long range, the muscle's working, you know, at its full capacity, at its full, at its full range of motion. So you want the muscle to be able to work in the biggest range it can. It's doing its job. It's bringing the arms down across the body. Like a fly movement would do the same. But try this out. My upper back is just looking angry. Look at that, stretching. I never realized how thick that upper back's getting until I watch a video of myself. I'm very proud of the accomplishments I made in my back. But see all that inner shit? Where the traps are at and everything? That's what you wanna thicken out with these exercises.
We finished our workout. The camera was gonna die, so we didn't do biceps. What'd you think of the workout?
Feeling pumped, boy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It feel good?
Yeah, it feels real good.
You get your lats all swollen and shit?
Lats, traps.
We took a couple pictures. We got legs tomorrow. Legs tomorrow. Oh, my legs are still kind of sore. That's gonna be it. I'm gonna go home. I'm gonna eat. Nick has work.
Shake.
I thought you were a shake weight model. So that's gonna be it. I'm gonna go home and eat, and I'm gonna answer some emails from my clients' diets. And
macros.
Diet training and everything. Flex on them. So that's gonna be it today. I'll have another video maybe tomorrow. I'm not sure yet. I probably won't be recording every workout because a lot of them will be the same. Trying to get this kid, I know Brandon, who's really good at video editing and recording. He's got a great camera too. I'm trying to get him to like follow us for a day and do like a reality show or something. because he can chop it up way better than me. Like, he does this for school or something like that. It's like what he does and what he enjoys. I like just lifting, and I do like this, but
lifting's up, putting down.
He's like passionate about video editing and taking, you know, pictures and photography and all that stuff. That's what he does. So he's a master of that craft, would you say?
Yeah, we're rookies.
And we're rookies. I try to dabble in everything. I try to be good at everything. And like better than average at everything, but not the best at a lot of things. It takes a lot of time to be the best at one thing, you know? So I'd rather average it out. Oh, look at that. This car's nice. I want to get one of these one day. Look at that. What is that, 6 Series?
Sunny South Florida.
South Florida. I live it down here. Everyone knows I'm from Boston, but I live down here now. I like it. So that's it. We're going to get La Granja, but we don't have enough time. La Granja. So taking off. That's it for today. And I'll see you guys again probably tomorrow or the next day.
Later.
Say bye.
Later.